Hi everyone, welcome back. In this video, I will show you how to categorize the Combobox pop-up list items using the grouping feature and its template. I will also show you how to filter the list items. Let me start with the code. I will open my existing application, which already has the Syncfusion Angular dropdowns package installed, and in the App module page, the Combobox module configured in the imports array of the NG module. In the App Component HTML page, I have included the basic Combobox component rendering code. With this code, you can visualize the employee list. Let's take a quick look at the employee data. I have bound it to the DataSource property. It has fields, employee ID, first name, designation, and so on. You can refer to my Angular Combobox Getting Started video to learn more about configuring the component. I've shared a link to it in the card above and the description below. Before moving on to the topic, let me run this application and show you the initial output. Look at the combo box. When I click the drop-down icon, the employee list is displayed. First, I'll show you how to categorize the combo box list items using the group by property. Open the App Component class, and in the field settings, I add the group by property and set its value to designation. Look at the combo box now. List items are categorized based on the designation. Next, I will show you how to customize the combo box list group header. I define the NG template with reference as group template. And then, add the context property, let data. In the template, I access designation from the context variable, data. I apply inline styles like font style, italic, and color, blue. See now, when I open the pop-up, the list displays the customized group header. Next, I will show you how to filter data items. I can enable or disable this feature using the allow filtering property. By default, filtering is enabled in the combo box. See, when I start typing the characters, items are filtered based on that. The default filter type is starts with. Other types are contains and ends with. Next, I will show you how to change the filter type using the filtering event. I assign the callback method on filtering. Let me define this method in the App Component class. I import the emit type from Syncfusion EJ2 base package, query from EJ2 data package, and filtering event arguments from Syncfusion Angular dropdowns package. I declare the variable data query and initialize the constructor for query. Then I frame the query using the where clause to filter the records based on the first name column. Set filter operator ends with. Provide the text typed in the input element, and set ignore case to true. At last, pass the data source in query to update data method to filter the data. Now the items are filtered based on the last character. I type different letters, and the employee names ending with that letter will be filtered. When you change the filter type to contains, employee names that contains the typed characters are filtered. I change back the operator to ends with. By default, combo box items are filtered ignoring case. When I type the character K, data will be filtered ignoring case. To filter the items with case sensitivity, disable the fourth argument, ignore case, in the where clause. Now see, list items are filtered based on case. Combobox also supports diacritic filtering. To enable this, I add the ignore accent property and set its value to true. In the App Component class, let me add a diacritic character to the first data source item. I will remove the filter event. Check now, when I start typing a word, diacritic characters are filtered. Let me recap what we have seen so far. I showed you how to categorize the ComboBox pop-up list items using the grouping feature and its template, and how to filter data items with different filter types. I also showed you case-sensitive and diacritic filtering. You can download a working example from the GitHub link in the description for this video below. I've also provided a link where you can see if you're eligible for our community license, which will provide you with a free license key to use our products. Thank you for watching this video. If you found this video useful, give it a like and subscribe to our channel.